Investigations into alleged mismanagement of the National Social Security Fund, NSSF, by the Inspector General of Government, Betty Kamia, has finally come to a conclusion. The report has vindicated the Minister of Gender, Labour and Social Development, Betty Amongi, for her role in amendment of the NSSF budget. The IGG noted that by the minister proposing a 6 billion budget for promotion of the entity was within her powers, and refusal by the former MD Byarugaba to consider the budget was a case of indiscipline. However, the IGG noted that the NSSF Act gives the minister excessive powers which can be used and recommended for an amendment to trim the minister's authority on NSSF budget.
We found that the Minister of Gender, Labour and Social Development is empowered under Section 29, Subsection 3 of the NSSF Act to amend the budget. So, the minister was within her right to direct amendment of the budget. Therefore, refusal by the managing director to include the minister's proposal in the budget for the board's approval was an act of insubordination, which should have been handled in accordance with NSSF disciplinary policy.
The investigations have implicated the former managing director of NSSF, Richard Byarugaba, and the director for finance, Stevens Mwanje, for causing the fund a loss of 4.4 billion shillings through illegal payments of staff who voluntarily retired early.
Through this voluntary early retirement, some people took advantage of the offers made. Some of them had only about 3 months left to the end of their contract, but they were paid hefty sums of money as if they were still had their contract running. We found that this policy was abused and caused a financial loss of 4.4 billion. Moreover, this policy was not covered, or rather, this expenditure.
The IGG noted that there was no law backing up this exit package and ordered the two, Byarugaba and Mwanje, to pay this money or face prosecution. Similarly, Byarugaba and Mwanje have been ordered to refund 687 million shillings, which was irregularly paid to the two board members who resigned from the board to provide vacancies to female board members, following amendments in the NSSF Act, which requires NSSF board to be gender sensitive. The IGG concluded that the two didn't advise the minister that creation of vacancies was done outside the law and didn't warranty compensations.
I'm going to now write to Mr. Byarugaba and Mr. Mwanje, asking them to refund the money.
Although the report by the Select Committee of Parliament, which investigated NSSF in March this year, implicated Minister Betty Amongi and recommended for her resignation, Kamia says she didn't find any fault against the minister.
So the minister made two directives, one on the budget and two on the board. And we find on the budget, she was within her authority. On the board, she directed that it be done within the law.
The report has, however, commended Byarugaba for overseeing tremendous growth of the fund for the 12 years of his stewardship from 1.7 trillion shillings to 17 trillion shillings.
During his tenure of office, the fund recorded remarkable growth of accumulated contributions and net worth from 1.7 trillion to approximately 17 trillion, a growth of 922%.
The probe was sanctioned on a request of the Minister of Gender, Betty Amongi, who acted on reports by whistleblowers. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.